Hello and welcome. Would you like to learn how to pass HTML or rich text from your SharePoint into your Word document template by just adding a token inside your template? Let me show you how. We'll start in SharePoint. I have already created a list called Company Announcements, and as you can see, the first entry contains rich text. And we want to migrate the rich text data to a Word template and also keep the formatting. Now let's look at our Word template. It is stored in shared documents. Our template is quite simple for this tutorial, but feel free to unleash your creativity as all you need is to add this token. The token will not only accept the data, but also keep the formatting from the source HTML. If you're asking yourself, what is a token? A token is a special placeholder that will process the rich text HTML data and apply it to the Word template along with the formatting. I have also created a folder called Invitations Final. That's where our result files will be saved. Next, we go to Power Automate and click Create. Select Instant Cloudflow and then Skip. We select SharePoint next, and there's a list of different SharePoint triggers. We need to pick for a selected item, as this trigger will attach the flow to the selected list in SharePoint. And we connect our documentation side and our list company announcements. In the next step, we are going to use a SharePoint action called GetItem. This action will help us get an item with the rich text data from the SharePoint list. Next, we need to select again the same site and the same list. In the ID field, we use for a selected item ID. And by using GetItem action, we will be able to select different columns from our SharePoint list in the next steps of the flow. And now we need to download the Word template we have looked at earlier. And for this, we'll use a SharePoint action called GetFileContent. Let's rename this step to GetDocX template so you can easily find it later. You can also rename any of the steps. For example, if you use the same action to get different files, just rename them to avoid any confusion. So again, we put our SharePoint site address and find our DocX template. Next step, we add Plumsail Documents connector called Create DocX Document from Template. This particular action will help us pass the rich text from SharePoint list to the Word template. In the template file field, we insert the DocX template we just got with the previous action. The next field is called template data, and it is an object that will be applied to our DocX template. In this case, we're applying the column announcement that contains rich text. In the document output type, you can select between PDF and DocX. We'll keep it as DocX. Our last step is to create a Word file with rich text data and save it in a SharePoint folder. We'll use a SharePoint action called Create File, and again, we select the same SharePoint site. In the Folder Path field, select the folder where you want your final documents to be saved. In the File Name field, we can select Title Column. This is possible because we used GetItem action in combination with SharePoint trigger for a selected item. And we also need to specify the file extension. Since we kept it in a Word format, we type .docx. But if you decided to convert to PDF, then type .pdf. And in the file content field, we select the result file from Plumsail action, create DocX document from template. And before we click save, let's rename the flow to something meaningful. For example, create announcement document. Now we can click save. And we will be able to run this flow in SharePoint. So let's go back to SharePoint and we select the entry we already have. And when we do this, an automate button shows up. So we hit the drop-down menu and we can see the flow we've just created. So click on create announcement document. And on the right here, we get information if we are signed in and connected to SharePoint and Plumsail documents. All looks good. Let's click continue and run flow. Great, it looks like our flow ran successfully. And now we can go to share documents and check if our file actually was saved. Here we go. The Word file matches the title bagels for breakfast. Great. Let's open it. And here we have our rich text in the same formatting style that we had it in SharePoint list. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below and we'll make sure to answer them in one of our future videos. And hit subscribe if you want to learn more about Plumsail, Power Automate, SharePoint, and other ways to automate your work so you can spend time on more fun stuff. And if you haven't tried Plumsail Documents yet, we offer a free 30-day trial that gives you access to all the features. Thank you.